Okay, I'd like to call the meeting to order. And first on the agenda is the hearing on the home occupation for Mr. Rosenheim. Would like to speak to that.
No, I want you to read the legal.
Oh, you gotta read the legal notice.
Yeah.
First of all, no, I don't have anything to add.
Okay, very good. Thank you.
The public hearing procedures are on the floor, if anybody's.
Oh, yeah. Well, you're supposed to announce that.
Okay, the public hearing, no, I'm not. The public hearing procedures are on the door, if anybody is interested in knowing how we operate a public hearing.
To whom it may concern, notice is hereby given that on Wednesday, December 11th, 2013, at 7:30 p.m. in the Sharon Town Hall, the Sharon Planning and Zoning Commission will hold a public hearing on the following: an application for home occupation under Article 3, 4.2.C by Robert Rosenheim at property located at 140 White Hollow Road in a rural residence zone. This application is on file in the Planning and Zoning Office, and at this hearing, interested persons may be heard and written communication received. The chair in Connecticut is 27th day of November 2013. This legal notice appeared in the Republican American Saturday, November 30th, 2013, and Saturday, December 7th, 2013. Now,
I'm going to speak first.
Okay, you speak first with the letter.
Is everybody familiar where Rosenheim's property is on White Hollow Road? He sits on 24 acres or 247.
20, I think it's 22 acres.
Actually. 22 acres. 22 acres. His driveway off White Hollow is a fairly long driveway, and it's the old Buckley house, I believe, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Sits back here. Plenty of parking around the whole property, but it's a pretty private location. There's 11,000 square feet in the house. They are proposing to use 834 square feet for their office on the first floor. We allow this under special exception for a home occupation, and we do allow up to four employees. They are asking for four. They operate Monday through Friday, 9 to 5. They were most recently in the second story of Union Savings Bank at Gay Street. And Ann Reagan is here, as well as Sarah Kuhn, who both work for him. Mm-hmm. If you have any questions.
Yeah.
How many, how many employees would be there at any one time?
There are four. Actually, three full-time and one part-time.
Okay, thank you. So it's all within the parameters of our regulations. Okay. Does any commission members have any questions? Does anybody?
Any visitors? Mostly phone?
It's, yeah, the business is conducted mostly phone, internet, email. Very, very occasionally there might be a client visit, but usually that is only clients who are also personal friends of Mr. Rosenheim.
Thank you.
Okay, any other questions by the commission members? If not, is there anybody who would like to speak for or against the proposal? If not, we did receive a letter by Michael Smith, 132 White Hollow Road, and it's regarding the application tonight. Dear commissioners, as I am unavailable to attend the meeting of the 11th, I write to express my concerns about the application for the home occupation filed by Mr. Rosenheim. My wife and I live next door to the Rosenheims, and we appreciated the beauty of White Hollow when we purchased our home in 2001, and have tried to do what we can do to be respectful of the natural beauty of the area. We did extensive renovation shortly after our purchase, which returned the home to closer to its original historical appearance. We purchased property behind our home. Our reason for buying the property was to keep its natural state and avoid any further development. In addition, we cleared the property abutting Mr. Rosenheim's of a large number of dead trees and diseased trees. My point here is that we continue to appreciate the natural beauty of Whitehall Road and have therefore tried to be good neighbors. And the many neighbors we have met have been good neighbors to us. We have not met Mr. Rosenheim. My concern is simple and straightforward. Having a commercial business operated out of a home by definition changes the nature of the neighborhood. I understand that the facade of the home isn't allowed to change, and the number of employees is limited to 4. And operations are only allowed during certain hours. Nevertheless, 4 employees arriving and departing, taking lunch breaks, and running personal errands is a lot of traffic when you consider this would happen every weekday. Sharon has area zoned for commercial operations. Mr. Rosenheim has an office in that area now. It is a commercial operation in keeping with the nature of the White Hollow neighborhood? It's a question mark. It's both our properties about state forests, and we enjoy seeing the wildlife in the area, turkeys, bobcats, bears. Do you want to introduce commercial activity in this area? What's the next on White Hollow? How many others can avail themselves of this option? And finally, would you want this next to your home when a commercial area is readily available? For the reasons I've raised, I respectfully ask the commission to deny this request and want to thank you for considering the issues I've raised. Are there any other comments or letters by the public?
Okay.
Okay, well, I think those concerns have been addressed. There's an allowed number of employees, as so stated by the applicant's representatives. And he's within the other parameters of our regulations. And I don't see any other questions here. We don't take this up on our agenda until the discussion, we'll have a discussion, the decision of the hearing at the new business on our agenda. Okay, if there's no more comments, questions, concerns, I make a motion the hearing be closed.
So moved. Second.
Moved and seconded, the hearing be closed.
Susan, you're an alternate. You're not voting. So
okay.
You can't be a regular member.
Second.
Okay. Motion made and seconded. Any further questions? If not, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
So moved. Okay, let's proceed with the minutes of the last meeting. Has everybody received them? And is there any questions or additions, concerns? If not, I hear a motion may be accepted as written.
So moved.
Second.
And seconded. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
So, okay, and the permits since the last meeting are being passed around. Under old business,
have you seen these?
Fire protection stand, is there
any
good movement on the hunting killed air Mets subdivision? No. Okay. No other old business, let's move on to new business, which is the discussion of the hearing we just had tonight and a decision. Did somebody move that we accept or deny the application?
I move that we accept the application of Mr. Rosenheim for an office because it meets the meets our regulations.
Okay, Betsy made the motion. Second?
Second.
I said by Stan. Any further discussion? If not, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? So moved. That's it.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, now we come to the election of officers. Anybody here that would like to be chair?
If we're open for nominations, I nominate Bart Kendall as chairman of the commission.
Second.
Further nominations? If not, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Well, thank you, folks.
Congratulations.
For another year. This might run to the expiration of my term. Now, we have also his office, officers.
Vice chair and secretary.
Vice chair. Vice chair is now Betsy.
I'd like to nominate Betsy Holm.
Second.
All those in favor say.
Will the nominations be closed?
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Okay, and Stan is the secretary of the officer of the commission.
I move that Stan continue as treasurer.
Secretary.
Secretary, excuse me.
Well, we can make him treasurer too. Okay, all those in favor, I hear the nominations be closed and all that, okay. All those in favor of Stan being, remain as secretary, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Here and Stan for another year or so. Okay, are there any other officers?
Nope, that's all you have.
Okay, good, good, good. Well, thank you for the comments, folks. You all received a copy of the bylaws, which have recently been thoroughly overhauled.
They seem fine.
They seem.
Maybe you'd want a workshop on one.
Yeah, we could have a couple of workshops on it. No, I think they're well done. I did thank Larry and Jessica in my last town report last year for the job they did, so. Okay, so I don't think we need any more work on that. Do we need to order additional copies of?
Yes, we have none available for sale. They're online, so we didn't.
It'd be nice to.
Correct, yeah, there's still people that want to come in and purchase them.
Pick them up.
So what'd you suggest, Jamie, 25?
I think maybe 25.
25, sure, we make money on it too, don't we?
More and more in Millerton, they have it on there.
We make what, $2 on it or something?
No, probably not more than that.
But I think it's a good idea to have.
Will somebody make a motion to that effect?
Make a motion, we purchase 25 copies of the zoning regs.
Moved and seconded, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Let's go for it. Jamie, why don't you just go ahead with your CEO report and give us an update on the collaborative?
The collaborative, I have asked Jocelyn to provide an update to me. So I would expect that we'd have that every month, starting next month. She didn't have time to get back to me. CEO, I don't have anything.
Yeah, that's great.
Wonderful.
Well, nothing more on the agenda. Do I hear a motion that we close this meeting?
That we close the meeting.
Thank you.